Hello students, in this topic or in this video we are going to discuss various input devices. So before continuing, I would like to tell you what kind of devices are known as input devices. So let me tell you one thing, and you should keep always in your mind that whichever device that can be connected to a computer and that is used for sending or feeding data to a computer in any form, all such devices are input device. I mean, any device through which we can feed data to a computer, all those devices are known as input device, through which we can give input in any form. We'll see how many forms of input may be there, but all such devices are known as input devices. Let us read it here also. In computing, an input device is a piece of equipment used to provide data and control signal. Mind it, control signal. Like any signal you send to an information processing system, that is a computer. This is called input device. The most common input devices are keyboard, mouse, scanner, digital camera, joystick. Joystick look like this. This is device for controlling devices, and basically these are used for games. Microphone, these things. So all these are common input devices. Okay. So let us see them one by one, the most common input devices. Nowadays, various new technologies are also there. We'll see them also, but first the keyboard. The most common type of input device is keyboard. This does not need any much introduction or a discussion. You all know what is a keyboard. Keyboard, look, this is a keyboard. Keyboard contains a lot of keys. So it is the most convenient device through which we can enter any kind of data. It contains keys. We press the key and the signal goes to the computer and that is input. So keyboard is human interface device, which is referred to as a layout of buttons. Each button or key, the buttons are also known as key, can be used to either input a linguistic character. Linguistic means language of any language, English, Hindi, or any other language. Keyboard may be in any language. Or to call upon a particular function using a combination keys, they act as the main text entry interface for most users. A traditional keyboard use a spring-based button. There is a spring. A spring may be made up of metal or may be made up of rubber. These spring button are there. When you press the button, it comes up. Okay. So, the newer variation employ virtual keyboards or even projected keyboards. Virtual keyboards. What are virtual keyboards? Look, these are virtual keyboards. The one which we use in touch a screen maybe, or projected keyboard means the keyboard is projected like this. See in the image, the keyboard is projected over the desk of a table, and when you type the keys, the sensor senses the presence of key over the button and it types. I mean, there is no button. It is projected either in a table or in a wall, anywhere you can. These are the new technologies about which you need to know. So this is projected keyboard. Virtual keyboard, you can see if you'll type this. So on a screen keyboard, then this comes. You can click. So this is an example of a virtual keyboard. You may, if your computer screen possesses touch screen features, then you can just directly type, touch the screen, and touch screen one of the input devices. Let us come to mouse. These all are very common input devices. Pointing device, pointing. Look at the arrow. This arrow. This is the pointer. And the device through which we point. That is, pointing device are used, most commonly used in input device today. The pointing device is any human interface device that allows a user to input spatial data to a computer. In case of mouse and touchpad, this is usually achieved by detecting movement across the physical surface. Look, you might be wondering that how, when we drag the mouse over the desk of the table, then how the cursor moves. This uses a technique through which, when you drag the mouse, the pointer also synchronizes on the screen. So you not need to know the technology, actually, how it is working and all. Just you need to know is that mouse is one of the input device, and as we drag the mouse over the desk, then the pointer also. So analog device such as 3D mouse is there. This, look, a computer mouse is a handheld pointing device that detects two dimension motion relative to the surface. When you drag the mouse to the surface, it detects the two dimension error of the motion. This motion is translated into motion of the pointer, which allows smooth control of the graphics. This is about the simple computer mouse. Okay. Joystick. This also may be used for pointing. And pointing sticks are something. This is called pointing stick. You may find such pointing stick. This is a look how it is located. It is located between the buttons. The size is very small. It's not too big. This comes in few commercial machines, commercial laptops. This is there. Most of you might have seen that. These are there. Through this also you can use to move the mouse pointer. Since these all are the input devices, which use the almost same similar technology which mouse uses. Okay. So examples of types of pointing devices. So mouse is a example. Touchpad, you know, touchpad that you see. This is the touchpad which you find on the surface of the laptops, which you use the fingertip to move it. This is called touchpad, okay? Remember this. Pointing stick, just I discussed this. This also comes with a few laptops, commercial laptops. Touch screen, today we all use the touch screen mobiles, tablets, or touch screen computer screen. So this is touch screen. Trackball is something similar to mouse, where a ball is there. We move the ball. These are the buttons. It works similar to mouse. So these all are the input devices. Look, joystick controller, which we see once again, composite devices. Composite devices means what? Input devices such as buttons and joystick can be combined on a single physical device that could be thought as composite device. It simply means that input devices such as buttons and joystick can be combined. Means two or more devices can be combined together to make a composite input device with a multifunction. Many gaming devices have controllers like this. Gaming devices combine features of a lot of things, a lot of input devices. So that may be called a composite device. So the example of composite device, this is a joystick. What is a joystick? Let us see this one. A joystick is an input device consisting of a stick that provide on the base and report it angle or direction on the device. A joystick is known as the control column. Actually, this is how a joystick looks. Most of you might have used it. Joysticks are also used to control heavy devices, but mostly these are used for controlling or playing games. A lot of buttons are there. You just move it and it controls the movement. Gamepad or something. Look at this, very familiar device, gaming pad. With the help of these game pads, we play games, computer games. And of course, you may use these devices for any other purpose also, but you need to become a good programmer in order to control these devices for other purpose. Another is, which is known as paddle. These are gaming devices. A paddle is a game controller with a round wheel and one or more fire buttons. Look at the round wheel. This is, and the fire button is in between. Where wheel is typically used to control the movement of the player object along the one axis, and paddle controller rotates through the fixed arc. Means it's a kind of input device which is normally used for playing games. It's not that common, but it is there. Look, few, these kind of devices are also there. These are called jog dial or shuttle, which are moved to, for look, jog dial, jog wheel, or shuttle dial, shuttle wheel, all are called with the same name. Is a type of knob. Knob, you know, which is used to, I mean, move like this, like a knob. Ring, wheel, or dial, which allow the user to shuttle or jog through audio or video camera, or video media, I mean. So these kind of devices you may find in video controller devices like camera and all, you may find these things, which helps to send some input signal to the, maybe found in the CD players, which are made of disc jockey and professional video equipments, you may find these devices. So these are not common devices. These are specific devices for specific purpose, like video controller and all these devices are there. So in this class, we are trying to see the input devices. Few input devices we are very, very familiar with, the one we see around. But here in this session, we are trying to see few more type of input devices, which are not that common, but we must have idea about them so that whenever we find or see some, we should not be like, what is this? We have never seen this. It must be in your mind that yes, these things, we know about it. So in this way, this WII remote is also known as colloquially as the Wii remote. It is a primary game controller for Nintendo Wii home video game console. It's a special game controller for a specific gaming console. Gaming console means a special device made for playing games only. And for such devices, special devices, you may find these devices there. Okay, uncommon, but yet it is there. Now, few video input devices. The devices through which we can input video to a computer. Digital camera, of course, we can connect digital camera and send video or photo to the computer. Digital camcorder, this kind of device is called camcorder. A camcorder is an electronic device originally combining a video camera and a video cassette recorder. Means where a video camera is there and a recorder is also there. The recorder which records the video in the tape, basically, video cassette. So combining these two words, this word is encoded, a camcorder. Camera that can record the things in a tape or any recording device. Portable media player, these devices, iPod and other devices, through this also we may input data to the computer, or we may take also the data. Webcam, we all are familiar with this device. In few laptops, webcam is just in the front, which is inbuilt. But if the webcam is not inbuilt, then you may have this kind of webcams. And this is webcam. This is input device, video input device, through which you can place it anywhere. Microsoft Kinect sensor. This is the line of motion sensing input device produced by Microsoft, first released in 2010. The technology includes a set of hardware originally developed by PrimeSense, incorporating RGB cameras. RGB means red, green, blue cameras, infrared projector and detector that map depth through either structured light or actually this is the motion sensor device. Okay. And if you wish to know more about these devices, then of course is a study. No issue. This is a motion sensor device. Image scanner, one of the most common input device. Scanner we need to scan the image. For few of you, these may be a very new thing for you all. I mean, you might be watching them for the first time, but no need to worry much. Whichever device is important, I'm discussing this in detail. A scanner is the one device which is common and very useful. What is the use of a scanner? Look, this is the structure of a scanner. You have seen a photocopy machine. The same way, this is the lead of that. We uncover the lead. We put something that we want to scan. We may scan a document. We may scan photos. We may scan anything. Just put it here, cover the lid, and give the command. And this device will scan that image to the computer screen where you can save that file. the photos that is getting scanned. So an image scanner, often abbreviated just a scanner, is a device that optically scans image, printed text, handwritten things, or an object also. Means if you have something like anything, a wooden piece of something, you can scan that also. Okay, it will scan it and convert that to digital image, commonly used in offices and variation of the desktop flatbed scanner and all. So this is an example of scanner. If you need to know more about a scanner, what you need to do, you just click this and this link will take you to the scanner, and we'll see a various types of scanners are there from the beginning till today, what kind of scanner we have been, how it evolved, how many types of scanners are there, flatbed, CCD, CIS. You can go in depth also, but we, in this class, we don't need to go in such a depth. We just need to have a light idea about what these devices are actually. So in this class, we'll try to cover as many as input devices as we can. We can see this so that whenever you in future will see any device that you should be familiar. Oh, I know about this. I have seen this. Fingerprint scanner, of course, you know this. Fingerprint scanner nowadays are common devices, which you may find the fingerprint scanner in the mobile screen also, in the mobile finger sensor is there, in laptops or for making attendance, a finger sensor is there. So a fingerprint is an impression left by the friction ridge of human finger. The recovery of partial fingerprints from a crime scene is an important method in this forensic it is not telling about. So in short, fingerprint scanner is a scanner which scans your fingerprint. Simple. Okay, nowadays it is used for a lot of purposes. So you can see a detailed knowledge of fingerprint scanner in this link. So for right now, I have given you enough example where fingerprint scanner is used. Nowadays in mobile phone, you may find it in a common way. Barcode reader. It is one of the most widely used input device which are used in malls, shopping malls, you know. You might have seen, actually, I need to go to this link to make you clear this. You need to be very clear about this. This is the barcode reader. Okay, barcode scanner, you may say also. What does it read? It reads a barcode. Example of barcode is not there. Let me show you. Image of barcode. This kind of code you may find in various products when you buy it from a shopping mall or when you buy it from a normal market. These are the barcodes. These bars, the lines, the bars. These are the bars. These lines contain some form of information recorded in them in the database. And the barcode reader reads the information in them. In shopping malls, you may find this when you purchase the thing and you go to the counter, when you give it, then the person there, what it does, it takes the item, it scans the barcode, and everything comes to his computer screen. Everything means the price of this other item, the name of the item, if there is any kind of discount in that item, then every information is fed and the barcode do the task of reading such information. And through this, what happens? The overall thing becomes very fast. So it is one of the input device, barcode. Again is 3D scanner. 3D scanner is the process of analyzing a real world object environment. Actually, the scanner which we saw here was the 2D scanner. Just scan the flat image. But 3D scanner scans a 3D model of object. Look. It can scan any object in 3D way. Means from every dimension it scans the object and give result in this form, in the 3D form. Okay. So this is making 3D model of Viking belt buckle, whatever. So 3D scanner is again a new technology which is used to scan an object in real life way. I mean, in all the dimension, from every side, that is called 3D, three dimension. Laser range finder. This may be one of the uncommon input device, but this is quite useful if you want to find the range of something. A laser range finder is a range finder that uses the laser beam to determine the distance to an object. The most common form of laser range finder operated on time of flight. Look, if you want to measure the distance of some object, then this range finder projects the laser beam to that object, and the distance traveled by the laser beam till that object determines the range or the distance of that object, and through that we find that object lie how much meter or kilometer away from you. So range finder is such a laser device. Another is eye gaze tracker. Eye tracking is a process of measuring either the point of gaze or motion of an eye relative to head. An eye tracker is a device for measuring eye position and eye movement. Look, this is again one of the uncommon input device, but it is used for what? Like, eye tracker is a device for measuring the eye position. Eye, where the position of eye and how the eye is moving. So this sense the movement of eye, and accordingly these devices may be used or are used in robotic devices. So audio input devices. So various different types of devices are there. Keyboard we saw, these are all game devices, video devices we saw. Now here comes the audio input device. Of course, the audio input device is microphone we all know. Even I am using the microphone. So microphone may be in any form. So microphone convert the sound signal to the digital signal, and that may be recorded also, or can be heard, or can be processed by a computer. MIDI means multimedia devices. Multimedia instrument, digital instrument. Okay, so MIDI keyboards are the keyboards which produces music. Look, these are the MIDI keyboards. Okay, like piano or other things which produces sound, and therefore these are also called audio input devices. So the sound produced by these devices can be recorded. So multimedia interface devices, these are. So in this class, we saw a lot of things, a lot of input device. Punched paper. These punched paper and punched card are the old devices. These are now not used. Okay. So let me show you the image, at least if it is available here. Like punch tapes are there. So these punch tapes were earlier used to record information in form of 0 and 1. Okay, look at the time. 1950s, 1960s, they were used, where the punch represented, the hole in this represented 1 and the no hole represented 1. And this is how 1 and 0 were represented. Look, punch tape or perforated paper tape is form of data storage that consists of long strip of paper that you can see in the image, in which holes are punched. Now effectively obsolete. Obsolete means nowadays they are not used. So they were used for recording information in digital format. That's it. So these all are the input devices. And we have a few more input devices which are there in your book. One is light pen. So This is one of the input device. What it does, with this light pen, you can directly draw something over the screen, or we use a pad where we write with that pen and the things get displayed over the screen. So that is example of light pen. You may see the image here, or you may find the image here also. Look, these are example of light pen. You can write over the pad and that get transferred to the computer screen, or you can directly draw something over the screen. So this is example of light pen. So rest all the input devices that you need to know are already discussed. So we'll see other devices in the next class. So see you, students, in the next class.